CyArk is a nonprofit organization based in Oakland, California, and our mission is to capture, archive, and share the world's cultural heritage. A lot of the sites are hard to access, and the greatest majority of people will never get to see them in person, and so being able to access a digital version of the sites, which we strive to make available, it's very important to us so that people can play with it, get inspired, perhaps one day travel to these places. Since 2003, since the inception of CyArk, we've been using laser scanning, or LiDAR, as our primary capture technology. So while laser scanning is great for capturing the underlying geometry of a site, photogrammetry is fantastic at capturing surface level details. So imagine the painting of a fresco or like the cracks and everything that's, you know, visible to naked eye. And through photogrammetry, we can produce super accurate 3D models that can then be quickly, easily shared with the community on the web. So reality capture is the first software of its kind that is allowing the users to combine laser scanning with photogrammetry. And so we can leverage the power and accuracy of the laser and then create meshes from it. And on top of that, create super high resolution textures using photogrammetry. We have been working with reality capture for about 2 years now. We were recently in Australia, in Melbourne, documenting the Royal Exhibition Building, which is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Some of the main features of the Royal Exhibition Building are the frescoes that are really, they're inside the dome, and they're really high, about 30 meters from the ground. And we capture them using phase one camera, as well as drone images. The lack of GPS data made it hard to fly the drone, so we had to go manual, which took two, three people, watching the drone closely, making sure we wouldn't hit the wall. So the capture team came back from the field with roughly 2 terabytes worth of raw data, about 10,000 images and 433 scans, which all went together into one RC project. Prior to RC, we do a lot of organization, given the high number of inputs that we have to deal with. And that comes down to a lot of naming, grouping images together by file type, you know, drone versus cameras, but also different features of the building go together. And we do that because we know RC works with components, and so we pre-group all those inputs, knowing that they will align together in single component. And then we go from smaller components into bigger, larger ones, until we have all the inputs we need into one RC project file. Our collaboration with Capture and Reality is allowing us to accomplish our core mission of supplying conservation drawings to the sites where we work, but also creating immersive experiences of the places to share with the world.